Schools across England are being urged to ban packed lunches in a bid to get children to eat more healthy meals. The two founders of the Leon restaurant chain were asked by the Education Secretary, Michael Gove, to come up with a school food plan, which they delivered today.
The changes in these schools happen because there is pressure from parents, from children. As a country, we are making ourselves sick with the food that we eat. And there is recognition now that the Department for Education can do more about this than the Department for Health, which is why Michael Gove has accepted all of the recommendations in this, or all of the actions in this plan.
Well, Jenny Tschiesche is a nutritionist and the founder of lunchboxdoctor.com, and Gemma Johnson's the chief executive of My Family Club, which helps families find ways to save money. Thank you both for coming in this lunchtime. If I can start with you, Jenny, 1% of packed lunches are reaching nutritional standards. They can't be better than school meals.
They're not currently, I agree, and that 1% that are meeting the nutritional standards are containing all of the things that we would like a packed lunchbox to contain. So that's fruit, vegetable, calcium, protein, carbohydrate, and a drink. What we do need to do is address the other 99% that still exist. I think those statistics are quite old now, and I do think people have got better, like the school meals have got better, but we need to address that even more, and that's exactly what I'm here to do.
What can people be doing then? What would you advise to put in a packed lunch? Because a lot of people think the easy things, grab a packet of crisps and a fizzy drink and send your child on its way.
Yeah, so what we want to do is think about what the packed lunch actually is. It's a meal in the middle of the day. Their school day is really important. It's as important in the afternoon as it is in the morning. So having a decent meal at lunchtime is really important. And I agree and concur with the school food plan on that. But what I want people to do is to be able to pick up things easily, that perhaps even from a supermarket, that aren't costing the earth, but that aren't just sandwiches, that aren't just crisps, that aren't just a fruity yogurt that's so full of sugar that it registers as high, i.e. 15 grams of sugar plus per 100 grams of product, according to the NHS guidelines, which is what most yogurts do. Most crisps are over the salt intake for the day, and those are the problems we face.
Gemma, do you think, in your opinion, it is affordable for parents to do healthy packed lunches? Because that's what we hear time and again from parents. Look, I don't have time, I don't have the money to come up with these five fruit and veg a day and all of the things that we're hearing are the right foods to have in
a
packed lunch.
You know, there's more and more families are actually turning to the Trussell Trust because, you know, they're just completely squeezed. And lunch boxes can be healthy. I mean, I've got three children. My youngest is 15 weeks old and my eldest is six. And we use leftovers from the dinner from the night before. So, for example, on a Sunday, we might have a roast chicken and I can actually use some of the leftover chicken and put it aside and make him a healthy choice the next day. I think grabbing for the sort of, you know, sugary and the salty snacks is all too easy. But, you know, with My Family Club, certainly one of the big areas that we cover is about meal planning and the importance of meal planning and staying within your budget. We talk to lots of mums on Twitter and Facebook and on the website, and some mums have a budget of only £40 a week for food. Paying £10 per child for a school meal is just not an option.
One of the options that have been suggested in this school food plan is to try and reduce the cost of school meals. And certainly if parents, apparently they're spending £1 billion a year on their packed lunches, if that money was reinvested into trying to make healthier school meals, do you think that would be a good use of the money?
It could be, but, you know, one of our mums has said, you know, her son came back from school and all he'd had was a small potato and some sweet corn because he was at the end of the queue and all of the food had almost been used up. So how do you guarantee that your children are actually going to get fed? It might be a healthier option, but do you know that your children are actually going to eat it?
And Jenny, how do you change that culture, that food culture, if you like? Because children, notoriously, they want bright colours, they want exciting foods. And I don't know if it was, as a child, my apple would come home uneaten in its packed lunch every single day.
Yeah. You want to make food interesting and exciting, but it doesn't have to be at a huge cost, and it doesn't have to take a huge amount of time. The biggest issues I think we've got culturally is that we've got people that are working much longer hours, parents aren't around as much, the culture of sitting down at the table in the evening is lost as well, so that's another issue. But what we need to do is just highlight what the things are that people need to be putting in the lunchbox, the six nutritional elements, a little bit like lunchbox bingo. You know, if you get all of the six nutritional elements and then you're away, you have a balanced lunchbox which meets all of their nutritional requirements.
Jenny and Gemma, both thank you very much.
Thank you.
Indeed.
Thank you.